the feel-good hormone. It is the hormone responsible for wewe reward systems. Tuseme you've done something, you've achieved something, that dopamine hormone is responsible for that. It's also the hormone that is released when mothers are lactating or breastfeeding their children. So it's very important. It creates the bond between a mother and a child. So it's a very important kind of what? Of hormone. So this is the feel-good hormone, and it is also the hormone that is responsible for what? For pleasure and for drugs. Known as a drugs, ketumia drugs, this is the hormone that is released a lot. And so that is why drugs are addictive. You keep wanting that feel-good hormone, that feel-good. And so you keep doing the drugs. And so that is why drug addicts, yani brain yako, survival of the busiest. So uki continue kuonyesha brain, unapata 70% spike of dopamine, feel good. When you take cocaine, your brain will want more of that cocaine. And so that is why it is a mental thing that controls your whole body. We know that hormones are the ones that drive everything in our bodies, right? Ibo. And so humans love information. And dopamine, feel-good hormone, inatolewa when you get new information. Like right now, the way you are listening is dopamine at work, because you want to know something new so that you help somebody else. And that's a good thing, because that is what helps us to learn, and that is what helps us to grow. And like that. But you know, that is also something that technology companies take advantage of, because they know we love information psychologically. Wanna release, wanna make sure our phones have as much information as you can ever desire. Why? So that you spend more time on your phone. So that means more money for them, because your time is their money. The pesa zao ni time yako. Facebook can say the average person and spend 58 minutes every day on Facebook, and that's actually a statistic. And so Facebook has 2.1 billion users in the world, and it's the biggest platform. So wakisema 58 minutes, hiyo ni pesa inaingia kwa account yao, because wataenda kwa Coca-Cola waambie, the average person 58 minutes. So kama unataka hata 2 minutes za huyu mtu ni advertise na sisi. So wanalipwa, and your time is the currency. And so that is how these technology companies work. That is why they make phones as addictive as possible for you, and even for young people and children, okay? It's good to understand that. We love technology. Love information. I want to show you on YouTube. For example, I was watching this video. Unaona hapa chini ya video, wanaendelea kukusuggestia some more videos that you can watch. This is the loving information bit that they are playing with your mind. Kwa sababu, hata kama nina watch hii, ninaona kaya hini, ninaona huyo na tip selfie. So, kabla nimalize hii nisha click hii. And so, that is how they keep you on YouTube for longer. You see how they work? They work on your brain completely. They use behavior engineers, and this is something also very important to understand. Behavior engineers, wanaitwa, and they sit and understand how the human brain works, hizi vitu zote zenye tunaelezea sahi, and then they ask each other, so what can we do to keep people more? And that is why kama hiyo, wanafanya such a feature. Okay, another thing I want to show you as parents, I'm going to go on Instagram and show you. This is my Instagram account. And so these are just some of the people and pages that I follow. So there's one thing I want you to see here. If to say many people speak to hapa, your love heart, the who inaonyesha nini, how many people have liked my photo. So every time I want to refresh me on how many people have liked my photo, I swipe down. Sinona ina load alafu inanionyesha. Swipe down, there's some time between the time you may swipe down na the time yenye inanionyesha. Think about gambling machines. Kuna kwanga na moja ya slot machine yenye unaweka pesa alafu unavuta a lever inazunguka, so your anticipation is rising, ikizunguka and then inaonyesha the final result. So that is how like Vegas, Las Vegas, people are addicted to gambling. You pull a lever, your anticipation rises, and then you get your results. So what did I get? That is what they've done with that feature, enye nimeonyesha, the drag down. One other feature is the infinite scroll. So nikiendelea kwenda chini,
sifiki chini, ona, sifiki chini, sitofika chini, nitaendelea, so kabla nifike hapa, zingine 50 zimejiload chini. So your infinite scroll is another way they keep teenagers there for 1 hour, 2 hours, 5 hours. And how did they come up with that? They use behavior engineers. Ndio wakuja waambie, isiwaiisha. Another thing is your inbox. If you receive message, what happens? Your phone vibrates and lights up. So as human beings in our minds, we are, if you're reading a book and then one panya imepita pale, utaangalia. That is how we survived when we were in the Stone Age na nini. And so making yourself read a book for 1 hour isn't easy. It's something you have to make yourself do. So what do they do if I'm reading a book and my phone is there and then it lights up? So I interrupt my thought process and I take my phone to check. So what does that do? It reduces my attention span. Kwa sababu nilikuwa nasomanga 1 hour, sasa siwezi soma 30 minutes bila kuangalia. Juu nimezoea ku interrupt my brain stem. Ikiendelea kusoma, interruption. Na wacha kenye nafanya, naangalia. And that is how my brain, survival of the busiest, ina adapt to being interrupted. So we are not paying attention and our children are not because of that. You see how they mess with our minds? One last thing I'm going to say about our brain. The feel-good hormone again. When you get a new notification, let's say you post a photo and then one person analike the photo. Kuna wenye huwa inawaonyesha kwa simu immediately. Mimi nimetoa hiyo feature. But hao wenye wanaonyeshwa immediately, it causes a 70% spike in the feel-good hormone, in the dopamine hormone. What does that mean? It is only 1% or 2% lower than cocaine, hard drugs. So your spike in feel-good hormone that is caused by one like is just like taking cocaine. So what have I done to my 12-year-old child? Remember, there's a small pocket of cocaine to use every day that haita waisha as long as I'm a post. And so that is why it's so important to talk about this topic. Steve Jobs is the maker of iPhone, Apple is his company. Alikuwa na introduced the iPad. And in his speech, what did he say? What this device is, extraordinary. It's the best browsing experience you've ever had. Way better than a laptop, way better than a smartphone. It's an incredible experience. So one day, after amesema hizo vitu zote nzuri, one day a journalist, after some time, alikuwa na interview, after the interview akamwambia, your kids must love the iPad. And this is what he said that shocked even the journalists. Alisema, they haven't used it. We limit how much technology our kids use at home. So the person who made the iPad, that is the best experience, his kids have never used the iPad 9 months after the iPad was released. Hiyo inakwambia nini? They don't even use what they create because they know the effects of it. So as alert as they are, so should we be. They don't use what they sell.